morning. Let's look inside the offices of the Okanahatchee County Department of Transportation. Emma has received approval from the director to pursue integrated corridor management and has set up a kickoff meeting with the Tiger team to formulate a plan. Let's listen in as the team discusses what integrated corridor management, or ICM, is, and how it works, and best practices for mainstreaming ICM as part of their planning processes.
Thank you all for being here. Wolfgang and I have been talking about the possibility of pursuing ICM since receiving the Okanahatchee County Quarterly Performance Measure Report. Travel time reliability is becoming a major concern, especially on the Victory Island Bridge.
Basically, instead of each of us independently managing our own systems, ICM represents a proactive, integrated approach for transportation operations agencies to manage the supply and demand when incidents occur within a multimodal corridor.
That's right. And ICM can help lessen the impact of incidents. This will happen by integrating existing ITS devices and systems, as well as assets controlled and operated by multiple agencies and stakeholders. That is all of us in this room today. We have to create proactive solutions for managing demand and capacity across modes. Remember the 70-car pileup we had due to fog?
Oh, yes, that was quite a day, particularly since safety has always been our agency's top priority. And none of my incident management plans worked.
Right. If we implement ICM, we can come up with integrated and proactive solutions to mitigate the congestion and reliability impacts of these sudden or non-recurring events.
So how does ICM work in practice?
We can hold buses or redirect them if needed for major events. I don't want my riders stranded when there is a problem in the tunnel.
What do you mean by integrated solutions?
Next time there is a catastrophe on the Komodo tunnel, what should I do to mitigate problems cascading into Alligator City? Do I call Sylvia?
That is not quite how this works. Let me walk you through what is ICM and what is not ICM. Under ICM, we cannot be reactive. We need to be proactive. It encourages multi-agency collaboration and coordination. That means you will need to work with not only Sylvia, but also Raj, Hua, Ronan, and Emma. ICM is typically implemented through a system called an integrated corridor management system with a decision support system, or a DSS. The DSS monitors traffic conditions in the corridor. It looks for atypical anomalies in traffic patterns or significant events. When an incident occurs, the DSS will model alternative solutions that can be implemented in real time.
For regions like Okanahatchee County considering ICM, it is critically important for us to mainstream ICM as a part of our everyday routine, processes, and practices of multi-agency planning, programming, developing, and maintaining the transportation system.
Without an effort to mainstream ICM into our transportation planning and system development practices, we're not likely to be successful in the long run. It will always remain a separate initiative. The county board will not fully support it, and they may underfund it.
The Federal Highway Administration has guidance and best practices for mainstreaming ICM. If we are to be successful, it must be integrated both institutionally and culturally. These are some of the best practices for integrating ICM across transportation agencies. Build on existing collaborative group. Ensure that there is at least one committed champion. Establish lead coordinator. Organize and train staff. Achieve multi-agency support. Gather support from elected or appointed officials and agency leadership. Engage participants. I see.
Transportation planning and programming shape the way we handle congestion. It plans infrastructure and technological investments. And our corresponding staffing and resources. Integrated ICM from both planning and programming perspectives brings increased value to these processes by increasing both coordination and collaboration. Some best practices are: adopt ICM-centric transportation goals. Use FHWA resources on organizing and planning for operations. Use analysis, modeling, and simulation tools to evaluate ICM. Incorporate ICM strategies into strategic and long-range plans. Integrate ICM into planning meetings and standard regional processes.
Incorporating ICM into our transportation programming is also important. It's key to the project's success.
Interesting.
We need budgetary and business process perspectives to further integrate ICM. Include ICM in transportation improvement programs. Ensure that project selection procedures consider the ICM impact. Utilize federal funding opportunities for ICM projects.
Once we incorporate ICM into transportation planning and programming, we must definitely include it in the project development phase. Plan for incremental deployment of your integrated corridor management systems. Use the systems engineering process. Use and update your regional ITS architecture. I hope you all have found this helpful. The goal for today was to provide a baseline understanding of ICM and how it works. Also, how we can mainstream ICM here in Alligator City.
Before we adjourn for the day though, can we get a quick show of hands for those who believe in the concept enough to take it back to their own office and begin to aggressively pursue an integrated corridor implementation?
That looks like a filibuster-proof majority.
Great. Thank you all again for attending today. We look forward to seeing everyone again for regular coordination meetings to get this started.
You've just heard Emma's story in this segment. How does ICM work? See you in segment 3, where we will discuss decision support systems.